deeply honored and very touched by this award. In many ways, I never expected that this is something that would be given to me. When my biographer started writing a book on me, I said I was still far too young, and I'm 61 years old. I just had this notion that to have a book written on you, you ought to be 75 and more. But he just said, I'm going ahead anyway, with or without your help. And I said, go ahead without my help, and he did. With this award, I always had this notion that it is only when you have reached Nelson Mandela's age, when he received this award too, that one would be in a better position to receive it. So I am humbled. I am not so sure that at my age I deserve it. But thank you very much, Sunday Times, for this honor. I truly appreciate it, and to the judging panel as well, thank you very much. But this award is much more than one person's award. I think it is an award that is to be shared by many other people. And it has been received by real pioneers in the past, people who have made a significant and lasting contribution to the development and the growth of our country, people like Bobby Godsell, Nelson Mandela, and many others who have received it. Such an award, as much as it honors an individual, makes a broader statement about the qualities that we seek in leaders, be they business leaders, leaders in communities, or even political leaders. Some of the qualities that the previous leaders had, those who received this award, have been qualities of being able to solve problems, being able to be so visionary as to be able to harness the diversity of our people and to be able to resolve problems that may have obtained at the time. This reminds me of a quote that was used by an ANC member in a branch in the Western Cape. When he was reflecting on some of these things, he quoted from Roxanne Lamond, when she said, the political and social and indeed economic climate that prevails in the world today emphasizes difference, emphasizes disunity, emphasizes destruction, rather than that are required to sustain human societies. I would submit that given the many challenges that our country faces today, this quotation is very relevant. And as leaders, in whatever sphere we operate in, we ought to be asking ourselves whether our approach, our attitude, our deportment is that of emphasizing disunity, emphasizing destruction rather than unity and building. We should, as people expect our leaders, be they business, be they social leaders, be they political leaders, to be far more engaged in the process of helping to build and to emphasize unity, to emphasize moving forward and doing things that can build our country. If we are to secure a better future for everyone, we need to agree on some form of partnership. Right now, in many sectors of our society, many people feel that we are pulling in different directions. What we need to do is to be finding the consensus building mechanism that we have developed as South Africans, what I regard as our DNA. It is within our nature as South Africans to find consensus, to be able to solve challenges that face our country. Many of us have a sense that challenges that we face today are getting us to move away from each other. And I think Roxanne Lalonde's quotation is very relevant here, that we do need to start gravitating towards each other and to find that constructive energy that will get us to work together in all spheres of life as part of our DNA to resolve our problems. This means that we need to shift the paradigm of our engagement as a people. Instead of making demands on each other, we need to be able to say, as various sectors of South African society, what is it that we are willing and able to contribute to the collective effort of building our country going forward? Next year, we will be in our 20th year of our democracy. And that is an important moment for a country, a nation that is in the making. And what we do need to do to say, can we rely on our national DNA to find consensus to resolve the many problems that beset our nation? The past recipients of this award were people who had great vision, people who had great courage, as well as deep commitment for what they stood for. There were people who took upon themselves the responsibility of leadership. Now more than ever, South Africa needs people, and many of us are sitting here today, who have vision, people who have the courage to lead, and many of us are leaders, as Michael Jordan was saying, and the determination to make a meaningful difference. Lastly, I'd like to thank the very many people who I have worked with, who have contributed immensely to me being awarded this achievement award. And many of you are sitting here, you've been partners in everything that I've done, both bad and good, criminal or otherwise. You've been part of it, I'd like to thank you. This type of award, in my view, is not an individual award. It, in many ways, is a collective award. So thank you very much for making a contribution to my life, to everything that we have achieved together. I'd also like to thank my colleagues at Shanduka, especially our CEO, Kuti Mahanyele, who is here, and the various staff members. It is through Shanduka that we've been able to achieve quite a lot of things. And lastly, and not least important, I'd like to give great thanks to my wife, who is the pillar that I rely on for everything that I have achieved. Throughout the years that we've been together, she's been my main support, and also my children, some of whom are here. I'd like to thank you, and in many ways, you have made great sacrifices to enable me to get to this point. And thank you very much for everything that you've done. And to all of us here, we have embarked on a journey. And it's a journey of developing this country and making it great. And let us now take the next stride. And maybe the Johnny Walker theme is important. We must keep walking, keep taking the next stride, and see our journey through, beyond the 20 years of our democracy, and much more in the future. Indeed, we are a great nation, and our greatness still awaits us. Let us keep striving to reach the greatness that we are bound to achieve. Thank you very much.